Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed, y'all. It's going to be a good night. I can feel it already. It's going to be a good night, Jay.
I'm going to introduce you first.
Sure.
All right, as I mentioned, I got some good friends that are... So you guys didn't know, like, tonight you're getting me, but you're getting some other people, too, because I got really good friends. And I invited them down to come and play with me. And the first one I got here tonight... is a good friend of mine that I've known for, oh my gosh, almost 30 years in the music business now. And it's this fine young gentleman here on piano tonight.
Not too young.
me and Jay go way back. We were in a group called Under the Lake, as well as a jazz fusion group out of San Diego, California. And it's funny because the way we met was really weird. We were at a Grammy after party, and Jay... his band was playing, and I was playing with another artist, and his sax player didn't show up. And so I heard the music they were doing, and I went over and said, "Hey, Jay, can I play with you guys? I like what y'all doing." And Jay, you want to tell me?
Who the hell are you?
And yeah, he did that.
And I was like, "Well, I don't think so." And I said, "Can you read? Can you read music?" And he said, "Do you have charts?" And I said, "Yeah, I've got charts." So I turned around and I said to the band, "Let's pull out this particular song," knowing it was the most difficult chart, because I was like, "You know what? I'm not going to try just anything and have this guy blow out our set." So we put the most difficult chart and played it, and it's really, really difficult because it's a fast tune, it's syncopated, and it's in unison with the guitar player. And Quintin played it and read it down, and like halfway through, you get tingling down your spine. And we ended up, and I was like, "Okay, you can play with us tonight, and you're in the band."
Yeah, so that's how we got started. And since then, it's been a great relationship with Jay over 30 years. And that song that we just played was a song off of Jay's most recent CD called Groove Together. So let's give a round of applause for Jay.
Thank you.
Good introduction, Jay.
And just want to take a minute to introduce the other players, except for that guitarist you'll introduce.
Yeah,
him, right?
Absolutely.
So you heard that we have a method to our madness. The soloist there on bass, Mr. Craig Shepherd. Local to Atlanta, but from Detroit. Very fine player. And our good friend Turtle back there, Thomas Jones on drums.
All right, let's give him a nice round. Okay, one last introduction before we get started with the next tune. This next young man is a very special guest of mine. As a matter of fact, he's so special, and he's such a special guest of mine that he's been a guest in my house for 25 years. That's how special he is. I want to introduce my son to you guys. Number one Billboard recording artist. Two-time Billboard recording artist. 4 weeks at number one, Lamech. All right, so that was a special guest. When I go, I'm like, "Look, bro, you come in and play with me. It's not an option, right?" All right, so we're gonna keep things rolling here. Thank you guys for the little talk break, but we're gonna get back to the music. This next song we're gonna do is a song that I wrote, and it just happened to be my first number one single of the Billboard Airplay charts. It's entitled Broken Promises. It's also the title of my new CD out, Broken Promises. So check it out. Thank you. Broken Promises. That's the title of my new CD out. Y'all having a good time now? I came and saw you. You having a good time? This is our house. We're going to have some fun tonight, right? All right, so this next song, we're going to bring up my son here, Mr. Lamech. And we're going to do his Billboard number one single that was on the charts for 4 weeks at number one. And I'll let him introduce that to you.
Hello, people.
How you doing? He kind of stole my thunder because he introduced that. I was going to say that. But like he said, all right, we're going to do this tune called Groove Central. This tune came out last year in, I think, like March or something like that. And by the summer, it spent 5 weeks at number one. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. But what he failed to mention was we actually had a very special occurrence happen with that single and that success because, as you know, we're father and son, right? But in the history of the genre, we actually achieved a feat that I believe nobody else has before because once my song went number one for 5 weeks, his single came out and kicked me out the number one spot, so I'm kind of salty about that. So he actually had a back-to-back father and son Billboard number one with his last single. So yeah, give it up for that. So yeah, we're going to do this tune called Groove Central. I hope you guys enjoy it.
Thank you.
the Mac on guitar, ladies and gentlemen. All right, y'all, how y'all doing? How's the food? How's the food and the drinks? All right, good. I want to thank the Velvet Note again for inviting us to come down. This weekend has been a tremendous opportunity and experience here in front of all you beautiful people here in Atlanta. And it's my pleasure to be here, so thank you. We'll slow things down a little bit. As I mentioned, me and Jay go way back. And this next tune is a collaboration between the two of us. We wrote this song. He came to me and said, Quintin, I need to do a song for a special person in my life. And I said, okay, what does Stacy want? That's his wife, y'all, okay. So we wrote this song and we titled it The Redhead That I Know. And her hair is red. Thank you. Let's give it up for Lil Mac on the guitar, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. That's the redhead I know. And Jay knows her very well.
And my wife always says that's the best song we ever do. Not that she's biased.
Okay. Okay. We're going to change it up a little bit.
Do you want to do that?
All right. So. All right. So what we're going to do, This is always kind of one of those things I throw at the band. It's a curveball. So me and Lameka is going to play something for you guys. I want to see if y'all know what it is. Okay? All right, so.
What? It's going to test your early 2000s pop knowledge. Well, trust me, as a popular artist, you'll probably know this.
Hopefully you know it.
Thank you.
right, raise your hand if you knew what that song was. All right, not bad. Very good. That was Daughters by John Mayer. Very good tune. And I like to do that song, although it says daughters, it really should be sons. Because all you fathers out there, be good to your children. And they turn out like this.
You know, Quentin, the worst part of that performance is that it is not on one of your CDs.
Yeah.
But the best part of tonight is that we each have our CDs for sale in the back. So if you like what you're hearing, you can take it home with you. And I know you could stream it or download it, but the best part of taking it home with you on a CD is you can take it home signed.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That's right. So for all of you who do not have our CDs, Lamech has CDs available in the back. I have them in the back, my latest CD, Broken Promise. And Jason Tipp also has his latest CD available in the back, too. And we'll be more than happy to meet you and greet you after the performance and sign them up for you, okay?
I'm back. What's up? So as he mentioned, we all have CDs for sale. So this next thing we're going to do is off of my CD. My debut CD came out last year, 2023, debut called Emergence. And we're going to do a tune off of that song, off that album, called Lifestyles. And this actually was the first tune that was recorded and written for that album. So I hope you guys like this one. It's going to be a fun one. Thank you.
Thank you very much. The name of that song is Lifestyle. And we're all in here living a pretty good lifestyle, would you say? Yes, indeed. I'm gonna let Jay introduce this next song because it's kind of special. And he wrote it for a very...
Are you
going
to steal my thunder?
No, I'm gone.
Go ahead. Yeah, so we're going to do a tune off of my CD. Little short backstory on my CD. Quentin and I, as he said earlier, we met a long time ago. And we've been recording six CDs with Under Lake. Yes. And Quentin's got five CDs out on his own. And we were talking about doing another Under Lake album. He said, you know, you ought to just do your own album. Just do your own thing one time. Try it and see. You know, you should really try it. So I took a gamble with the... And reached out to a producer and co-wrote with Darren Ron that first song that we played at the top of the set, Grooved Together, and that went really well. So then I decided to record an entire CD. And there's a really funny story to this song. This song we're going to do, it was influenced by something that a piano player that influenced my musical career a lot said, and I made a song out of it. I heard what he said, and I kind of wrote a melody. And then I played it for Adam Hawley, the guitarist, as a song that maybe we would work on together and produce. And Adam said, you know, I like the first eight bars, but I don't like the rest of it. So we took the first eight bars, and we'll play that song for you later. That was actually a big hit for me. So good on Adam. This one is still one of my favorite tunes, and it was written in honor of Bob James. It's called Bob's Groove.
Thank you very much. That was Bob's Groove by Jason Tip. Just checking time. Y'all good out there? We can keep playing? All right. I'm going to switch over to this microphone. This microphone kind of went out, but I'm still good. Y'all good? I'm good. All right. Yeah, I'd like to introduce this next song. It's off of my latest album, CD. And it was my third number one Billboard hit. It's entitled Tell Me Something. much. That song is called Tell Me Something off of my new CD. And y'all got something to tell me? Y'all got to tell me something. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. All right.
Time to roll.
Yeah, it's time to keep rolling. Let's
so go. That song I mentioned earlier that Adam Hawley said, the last one he played, Bob's Groove, and he said, I like the 8 bars, I don't like the rest of it. He took the 8 bars, we worked together on the 8 bars, and we wrote this song, which was number 15 on the charts and was in the top 10 most played on Sirius Watercolors for 90 days.
Jason was, I just checked it actually. Jason was on Sirius XM top 10, I think it was for almost 3 months. Yes, so that's an amazing deal. So kudos to Jason, give him a round of applause.
Thank you.
We had to get a drummer some, y'all, you know.
Thomas Jones on drums.
I want to thank y'all for coming out tonight. My name again is Quintin Gerard. Jason Tipp on keys. Let's give him a round of applause, y'all. Lamech on drums. Turtle on the drums, and Mr. Craig on bass.
You ready for another? You want one last one?
Now, do we have time?
We have time. Okay. We have time. We don't. We're going to take too long.
Yeah. All right, we got time for one more. Y'all want one more? All right, we're gonna do one more. Thank you so much for all the love y'all giving us. Appreciate it. And okay, I already see what he's playing here. So what we'll do is we're going to take this back to our jazz roots and jazz history. This is a song that most jazz musicians know, and we have to learn, and we're going to give tribute to Joe Zawinul and Cannonball Adderley on this song, and it's entitled Mercy, Mercy, Mercy. Funky, I can give it one hand, y'all. Thank you very much. We enjoy playing for you guys. Y'all have a great night. Enjoy the meal, and thank you. Hopefully we see you again.
And if you buy a CD, we'll come out. We'll be out to sign in a few
minutes. That is correct. If you purchase the CD, we'll be right back. I'm going to get a towel and dry myself off, and I'll meet y'all in the back. Thank you again. Thank you again to the Velvet Note for having us. It was a pleasure to be here. Thank you. talk back. Mic check. Oh. All right. How's everybody doing today? Welcome. My name is Quintin Gerard W., and I want to welcome all of you to the Velvet Note tonight. And we got some music lined up for you here, and hope you guys enjoy. You guys ready to have a good time? Okay, that sounds like St. Louis. Y'all ready to have a good time? That's the ATL. That's what's up. I've got some special guests up here with me tonight. See, I brought a little surprise package for you guys. So I know you guys didn't know that, but as we move along, I'll kind of go through that and explain what's going up here. So we got some treats for y'all. All right, but we're going to get started. We got a wonderful gentleman here that I've known for over 30 years who was on stage with me tonight. Mr. Jason Tipp on keyboards, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, and we're going to open up the set with a song that Jason wrote, which was on top. Okay, all right. Well, it was on the charts on Billboard, so he's got a couple of them on there. So we'll go with that one first. And the song is called Groove Together. Thank you. All right, thank you. All right, again, I want to thank everybody for coming. How y'all doing out there? How's the food? Good? Oh, okay. I'm going to leave that alone. Bourbon, how's the drinks? There you go. How's the drinks? There you go. All right, we're going to open up with Groove Together, a song written by Jason Tipp. I'd like to do this next song. It's the title song from my latest CD project entitled Broken Promises. And I'm happy to announce that it was my first ever Billboard number one hit in smooth jazz charts. So I guess that means the song doesn't suck. Thank you. All right, how y'all doing? That was Broken Promises, the title of my new CD. All right, all right. Yeah, I'm gonna get a drink of water. All right, as I mentioned, we got some special guests on the stage with us tonight. And
right off, we should give a hand up to Craig Shepherd.
That's right, Craig Shepherd for that bass solo on the first song. All the way from Detroit, Michigan. Yes, indeed. All right, this next person I wanna introduce to you guys is very special to me. And so special to me that this person has been living with me for the last 25 years of his life. I'd like to introduce... I'd like to introduce on guitar, ladies and gentlemen, Billboard number one recording artist and my son, Mr. Lament, on guitar.
How y'all fine people doing tonight? Come on, y'all doing better than that, right? Yeah, I know y'all eating and stuff, but you know, I think y'all can show a little bit of energy. But yeah, we're gonna have some fun tonight. So, as that lovely introduction he gave me, my name is Lamech, for those who don't know. I'm a smooth jazz recording artist, and I'm a little bit new to the smooth jazz scene, but I've been welcomed with open arms. I'm thankful to be performing here for you guys tonight at this wonderful venue called the Velvet Note. I want to give a shout out to Tamara for having us and all of you guys for attending. This is beautiful. Give yourself a round of applause. Yeah, absolutely. So a little backstory about this song. As you may have mentioned, this song spent 5 weeks at number one on the Billboard charts last year in 2023. And something special happened about this. In the history of me, of course, being alive, but in this history of the genre, it's never happened with this thing I'm about to tell you. I had 5 weeks at number one. The sixth week, this guy came out of nowhere and kicked me out the number one spot. And he just decided, like, okay, yeah, I need to take the throne for a little bit. So we actually had the first back-to-back father-son duo number one on Billboard in history. Yeah, absolutely. And so that was a historic monument, and you know, it's an honor to be able to share that title with him. So this is Groove Central. We're gonna play this for you guys. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lamech. Give it up for Lamech on guitar. Yeah. That oatmeal worked out when he was 3 years old. Yes, indeed, boy. He's something else. Boy, I tell you what. Ladies and gentlemen, this is what happens when you take care of your children and you invest in your children. So if you guys got children out there, hey, man, take care of them, invest in them, give them all your love, okay? And they turn out to be like this. So I'm very proud of him as a father. All right, so we're gonna continue the show. We're gonna slow it down a little bit. This song is a very cool tune. It's kind of special as well. Jay and I, as I mentioned, we've known each other for almost 30 years, and we've done many albums together with another group called Under the Lake. It's a jazz fusion group out of San Diego, California. And he came up to me and said, "Quentin, let's write a ballad for this next CD. And I want to do it for someone very special in my life." I said, "Okay, Jay, what does Stacy want?" Stacy is his wife, okay? And so we wrote this song for Stacy, Jason's wife, and it's entitled "The Redhead I Know." And her hair is red. Thank you. Guitar, y'all. Thank you. You know what, ladies and gentlemen, I wasn't going to do this. I wasn't going to put him on the spot. I wasn't going to put him on the spot, but I've got a special guest here today. This young man, well, this man sitting over here in the corner, I have not seen since 1986 when he sat next to me as the first chair alto sax player at the Loyola University Jazz Band. His name is Richard Lavelle, and he's a great friend of mine. Stand up, Richard. I want to let you guys know he was there with me. Yes, indeed. Richard Lavelle. Give him a shout, y'all. He was right there with me, and I was a freshman in college. And what were you, Rich? You were a sophomore, junior, right? Something like that?
I don't know. He was a little kid, so yeah.
Yeah, great saxophone player right there, and I have not seen him literally since 1986. And he caught me on Facebook, and he said, I'm coming to your show. So I'm so grateful that you're here, Richard. Thank you for coming.
Good to be here.
So are you? Yeah. All right, so we're going to keep this going along, and... right now, I'm going to do a father-son thing for you guys. Y'all would like to hear that? All right. We're going to do a father-son thing. But we're gonna kind of do it in a manner in which we're going to get the crowd involved. You guys want to get involved? Have some fun? Okay. Basically, we're going to get you to name this tune. All right? So I'm going to just leave it at that. See if you can name this tune. How many of y'all know this song already? Raise your hand. Thank you very much. That was, for those of you who don't know, that was Daughters by John Mayer. How many figured that out? Raise your hand. She got a couple people. All right. So, you know, we can't leave the daughters out. So we got the father and son duo. So we're going to give that out to all the daughters out there. So be good to your daughters.
So I think I might have seen some folks doing videos, which is fantastic. But we should tell you to tag us on social media. It's Funky's at FunkySax, FNKYSAX, is Quintin. Oh, Instagram. Yeah, well, that'll get everything.
Okay, yeah.
And you're just at?
Lamech Music, L-E-M-E-K Music.
Yeah, go over to my Facebook page, because I think I got like three people over there. Quintin Gerard W.
I'm one of them.
Yeah, that's one right here and that one right there. There's three people, so.
I'm back. How y'all doing? Y'all feeling good? That's what's up. So, I don't believe we've mentioned it tonight, but we actually have CDs for sale in the back. So if you like what you hear tonight and you want to take it home, please, please indulge. We have plenty of them to go around and we'll sign them as well. And so this next tune we're going to do is actually one of mine again. It's off the debut CD of mine called Emergence, and it released last year. And fun fact, this song was the first tune that was written and produced for this album, and I think it's one of my favorites personally, and I think you guys are going to enjoy it as well. So this one's called Lifestyles. Hope you enjoy. We'll be right back.
Lifestyles, ladies and gentlemen. Let me on guitar again. All right, do we have time for, what time is it? Do we have got time for one more?
We got time for a couple more.
Y'all got, y'all want one more song?
Five more.
Where'd you say five?
Is there bids? Like, there bids?
Two more. Them people talk fast.
Yeah, so well, the next one we'll do is...
Yeah, go ahead and introduce this song.
Yeah, thanks. Next song we're going to do is off of my CD. We talked about the CDs. Their CDs are back there, right? We talked about that?
I don't know.
I think Lamech talked about that. So Quentin and I have been working together for 30 years, he said earlier, and we recorded 6 albums together as a band with some other folks, some other really good players, and he encouraged me to record my first solo album, and first track we played, Groove Central, Groove Together, we each got a groove on one of our albums, Groove Together is on that album, and this song was on that album, and this song, I was really inspired by something, a piano player, jazz piano player who I'm inspired by his playing, said something publicly that inspired me, and the way that he said it triggered a melody line in my head, and I wrote this song, and it's written for Bob James. It's called Bob's Groove.
Thank you.
right, Bob's Groove. Bob's Groove.
Burning it up.
You guys are so quiet. Should I talk quiet?
No.
I talk loud. Okay. Where we at? We got time for. We got enough time. We got a couple more songs we're gonna do. We got plenty of time. All right. So let's go ahead and do this. This song is on my latest CD again, and it's a historic track for me. It's the third single that I released off of this album, and it was my third consecutive back-to-back-to-back number one single on Billboard. That's hard to do, y'all, so I'm blessed. I don't know where it came from, so I'm going to go ahead and perform that for you guys tonight. It's called Tell Me Something. So y'all got to tell me something after the show, okay? The name of the song is Tell Me Something. Thank you. Yes, indeed. Tell me something. Number one on the Billboard charts back, what is this, July? No, that's June.
Back in April.
Back in April. Yeah. Okay, Jay's got a stretch. This is the seventh inning stretch. Do another song off of Jay's CD because, you know, we want to give everybody some ample time here, and this is a great song we got, and Jay called me and asked me to play on it, so I was like, yes.
So we played Bob's Groove a little while ago, the one for Bob James. So originally this tune was part of that tune, and I played it for Adam Hawley, guitar player, producer. He produced it, and he said, I like the first eight bars. We can do something with that. Get rid of the rest of it. And that ended up being Bob's Groove.
Yeah.
So we took the first eight bars of what was originally Bob's Groove, and we made this tune. It's called Time to Roll. And it was number 15. This was number 15 on the Billboard chart. And for 90 days, it was one of the top 10 played on Sirius Watercolors, yeah, this year. So and Quintin was on it, yes, and did a great job. So. Of course, absolutely. This is a tune called Time to Roll.
Thank you.
We had to get a drummer some now. Get Turtle some on drums, Turtle. Thank you, guys. We appreciate playing for y'all tonight. It's been a pleasure. And we want to thank you for coming to the Velvet Note and welcoming us here, bro. It's been a pleasure to be here. And I'd like to thank all the people on stage with me tonight for helping out tonight. Jason Tipp on keyboards, Lamech, Turtle, and Craig on the bass back there. So give the band a round of applause, and I appreciate all of you. Do we have time for one more for an encore? Or we got time for more? One more, y'all. Y'all good? Or one more? All right, we'll do. We got time for one more song. One more song. Typically, you leave the stage and come back, but I'm not leaving and come back. We'll just do. Okay, I think I know what he's playing. So. All right, so as jazz musicians, typically what we like to do somewhere in the set is pay homage and give credit to some of the great musicians and artists that came before us to teach us how to play these things, right? So we're gonna go back in the book here, and we're going to pull something from our repertoire that's kind of historic. And we're going to look at Joe Zawinul and Cannonball Adderley here. And we're going to do a tune called Mercy, Mercy, Mercy. Jay wants to see how funky I can play with one hand, so let's see. Yeah. Thank you very much. Good night. Again, thank you for the Velvet Note, and we appreciate it. I'm going to pass the torch.
Quintin Gerard W, live at the Velvet Note. Could anybody ask him what the W stands for? What does the W stand for?
Wednesday.
Okay.